part man, part machine, all reboots. We are looking at the remake of RoboCop. And, you know, on this episode of The Real Deal, we're just going to do a quick short look at this. Not going to get into spoiler territory because we don't want to ruin it for you for those who are interested in seeing it. But so we're just going to give you our thoughts on it. I'm Kevin Polly.
And I'm Brian Hatcher.
Welcome to the Man Attic for this episode of The Real Deal. Now, Brian, you and I went to go see the RoboCop remake. Mm-hmm. Saw it on a matinee. Not going to complain about the fact that we got matinee prices for this.
Yeah.
You know, you and I are both kind of in that middle of the road. Now, we've had a couple days to think about it. So now, how do you feel about this film?
If I had to describe this movie, I would call it Diet RoboCop.
That's a fair analysis. And I think when you take an R-rated, very graphic, you know, film and turn it into something PG-13 mm-hmm. and a little more, I guess, sanitized would be the best word for it, it does kind of lose a little something. And I'm not saying that from a gorehound perspective, but the film, I think, for me, where it lacks is it doesn't have the bite. It doesn't mm-hmm. have the satire. It doesn't go for the jugular that the 87 film did. This feels very, by the book, safe. Mm-hmm. That's not to say it's a bad film. It's just very, it's vanilla, I think would be, and that for some people might actually be the worst thing you can say about a film. Make me love it, make me hate it, make me feel something, don't make me feel middle of the road on this.
You know, and the thing about it is, I always like to give a movie, even if it's a reboot or a remake, I always try to view it as its own film.
And you have to.
Yeah, because it really is unfair to hate a movie just because it's not exactly like, you know, the film that it came from.
You want it to be a little bit different.
Exactly.
You want to have some surprise because if not, then what's the point? Just watch the original.
But at the same time, when you remake a film that had the popularity of a RoboCop, there is that implied promise to the audience that if you like the first movie, you're going to like this one. And it really doesn't deliver in the same way.
Yeah, it's a screenplay that feels very generic action film.
Yeah.
It's like someone took the cliff notes of RoboCop mm-hmm. and made a by-the-numbers PG-13, sanitized for all audiences kind of look. Now, the film does have action. Mm-hmm. I will say that the sequences with RoboCop on his motorcycle where he's like scanning through things, like it's kind of neat how his database works with the CCTV cameras, the police database, all of this interfacing all at once while he's also doing his thing. Some really neat visuals there, and Jose Padilla definitely brings mm-hmm. the action. But it's the difference of, you know, Peter Weller's RoboCop with this machine gun type handgun that just obliterates people, and then you've got this RoboCop who has tasers.
Right.
It definitely, for fans of the original film, I think it kind of, you almost have to kind of laugh sometimes mm-hmm. when you see it, because it's like, man, in the original, these people would have been like sawed in half, basically, and now they're just like, we're knocked out. It's almost like there's someone on the other line, like they're trying to make sure that the parents who come see it, it's like, it's okay. Mm-hmm. It's okay, they'll survive.
Yeah,
it's almost like that's what they're trying to reassure you.
Oh, absolutely.
It's like they tried to make an adult comic book film, which is what the 87 film was, let's be honest.
Right.
It was basically Judge Dredd before we had Judge Dredd. And turn it into something that's almost, I'm not going to say family friendly, but definitely more wide range of audience.
Yeah, and you know, the thing about it is, that wouldn't even have bothered me so much. But, of course, I am, you know, as a writer, I am a story hound. I live and die by story. And this script really just skims the surface over so many things, but never really goes into any
particular. There's so many really good ideas. I mean, you know, the original definitely has a huge satirical look at 80s culture, especially mm-hmm. the yuppie culture. It also looks at just the United States' like bloodlust and our love of the Second Amendment. And it really plays on those ideas. And in this film, it really wanted to go for, I think, the sort of dehumanization of war, the whole drone mm-hmm. thing. And again, great idea, but they dance all around it but never commit to it.
Yeah.
His family's still in this one. Mm-hmm. Dance all around the implications that would have, but never commit. This time, Murphy is aware of who he is. And again, dances around the issue but never commits to it. And there's so much of that in this film.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, the one thing about this great, and we'll get more into this when we do a more in-depth and, more, of course, more spoiler-involved
yes.
analysis of the new RoboCop movie, but I will say that the one problem I have with the screenplay is it's safe.
That, you know what, really, that's the biggest thing about it.
And in an action film, safety kills your
movie. It really does. You know, you've got a great cast. I mean, when I first heard about it, it's like, wow, you've got Michael Keaton, Gary Oldman, and Samuel L. Jackson in a science fiction action film. Now, if you know me, that's like someone in Hollywood just found my happy button on my brain and just pressed it. And you just didn't give them a script that was worthy of their work.
Oh.
They do everything they can. Even Joe Kinnaman, as Alex Murphy, does what he can with the role. It's just there's not a whole lot to sink your teeth into.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not to say the original RoboCop is Shakespeare, but it definitely had an idea, and
yes,
it commits to it, and it plays it to the hilt. And in this, it does. It feels very PC RoboCop, mm-hmm, and I don't need that in RoboCop. I don't want that
right
in RoboCop. Now, for parents who are watching, if you are concerned about the film, if your kids are interested in it, I will say this. It is PG-13. The violence is there, but again, he's using tasers, so there's really not, like, the blood. There is some intensity at the beginning, but beyond that, it's just really kind of a generic action flick. Think of what you'd see normally on TV where people get shot and they fall down. You don't see the blood, a lot of that. Again, there are some cool sequences. I will say when you do see the revelation of what is left of Alex Murphy, that really surprised me they could go that far for PG-13. That's actually kind of disturbing. If there's anything that kids are going to get turned off by, that's going to be it. But I think if you've got kids in that 10 to 13 range, that tweener range, they'd probably really get a kick out of this. I think when I was that age, I would have gotten a kick out of it,
mm-hmm,
had I not had the brilliant 87 version when I was that age, seeing that at the Valley Drive-In. So, you know, it's definitely, I think I'm kinder to it than you are.
Oh, yeah.
Would you watch it again?
No, I wouldn't. And I think mostly because there's a little bit of a fear in me that if I were to watch it again, I would just see more of what was wrong with it.
Well, I'm a little bit more generous to it than you are, although I really don't think I would watch it again unless someone paid for the ticket. That's fine. Mm-hmm. Definitely don't have an urge to own it. But what did you think? Have you seen it yet? And if so, let us know in the comments below what you think of it. Are you a fan of the remake? Did you think it was unnecessary? Do you think, like us, maybe there were some ideas they could have capitalized on but didn't? Or do you just have no interest in it whatsoever because the original one is so awesome? Or do you have no interest because I don't care about RoboCop? And if that's the case, you're un-American. But anyway, let us know what you think. Like and subscribe. And, of course, you know, share this with your friends on social media, the social media of your choice, Facebook and Twitter. We're out there on both, also on Google+. Let us know your thoughts. As always, you are a part of the conversation here in the Man Attic. We're always glad to have you. So to all of our Man Attic fanatics out there, I'm Kevin Polly.
And I'm Brian Hatcher.
We'll see you next time for a more in-depth look at RoboCop 87 versus RoboCop 2014. Until next time, take care. We'll see you soon.